with some friends, because you don't want to say that you want to have a worship night, because that might be a little weird. You just have some friends over, you have to sing worship songs. You build your altar to God. Everybody wakes up in the morning, and somehow, rejection is this huge thing. And your family is upset. And your friends are upset. And everybody wants to know why they didn't get to worship with you. Who do you think you are? And this is how we do things. And it turns into a big deal. And you're like, well, I was just trying to. Awkward. Doesn't that sound discouraging? But every time a discouraging instance like this happened, he kept going. He took another step forward, and another step forward, and another step forward. And now he is with more proof from God that he is who God said he was. And the stakes are getting higher. And no one else around him is agreeing with him yet. So he gets all these people together, and the Lord said to Gideon, the people with you are too many for me to give Midian into their hand. Because then Israel will boast over me, saying, I've done it, not God. Finally, Gideon has backup and people with him for the first time. Finally, and God's like, too many people with you. Because if you guys do it now, you'll be like, oh, we did it together. We're cool. When God was like, me, my glory. Because the whole point was, just like what Gideon said in the chapter before, when he was like, where's God been? The whole point is God showing, here's who I am. It's not God being selfish. It's, you guys, if you don't believe that I will protect you and defend you, allow me to show you that. And don't let anything steal credit from this, so that this generation can see the work of my hand. It's not that God is a glory hog. That God knows we need to see him.